I need you to put your hands on the side.
What? Because the guy would let go.
Oh. You don't even have to be close to each other. Okay, I don't like to touch guys.
Yeah, I do. Now, we kind of think the cross bridges are a little slower than regulatory protein. So while this fentanyl may want to relax, so at cross bridges, but eventually they're going to off. Okay, I got to detach, detach, and detach. But what we can find is actually bend the cross bridge get back in here. What we find is one attached cross bridge may actually hold a good bit of that thin film in the back. And then what can happen is you can have to get back in there. What's going to happen? Okay, then you can get back. Okay, eventually we all relax. Okay. So this is trying to demonstrate that there's a real interaction between the regulatory proteins and the actin and myosin. It's not like the regulatory proteins are just like a switch that turns on and off the thin filament. In a way, the myosin, which is the motor, gets in there, it's going to affect the thin filament, it's going to make the units bind calcium more strongly. And one or two cross bridges may hold that whole thin filament permissive, which could allow some small amount of, say, regenerative binding cross bridges.